You're forgotten in history, bro. That's what you just did, Bernie.
His greatest contribution is going to be AOC.
Maybe. Maybe. And we'll see what happens with her. She seems to be...
She's a star, yo.
She's a star, but she seems to be towing a party line, right? She's not fucking with the Mozilla girls anymore, right? She used to be with them, the girl gang, this, that, the other. And all of a sudden, she's not talking. She's not talking about Biden being senile. She's not talking about the Democratic Party. Like, she's real quiet all of a sudden. And I think they tapped her. They said, hey, listen, you could have a future within the party. Shut your fucking mouth. Shut your fucking mouth. Stop going on Twitter. Stop yapping. Stop going in front of Congress and yapping. And you know what? The second you give them the opportunity, all of a sudden they get real fucking quiet.
I don't know how old she is, but I feel like that might be the first female president.
Oh, come on, bro.
Yo, I think she's a star. Whether you...
Why? Why
I don't know that? Any of her politics. I don't really
politics
care.
Politics don't matter.
I just watch. She's just a star.
Politics don't matter. Intelligence she doesn't matter. Is. None of these things matter. It's a likability contest.
I think she's a star. She's cute.
She's so unlikable, informed. Though.
She speaks well.
Say again?
People didn't fuck with her. They ate not that bitch up, enough, yo. They think. Ate that bitch up. And I'll vote for her because she's Hindu. So nah, straight up, let's
I
go.
I agree with you, though.
That's as close to Indies I'm
AOC,
gonna get.
Man.
Yeah.
AOC.
That's people, they're just like, yeah, I'm ready. AOC, let's go.
I don't think she's likable.
You and just
Bernie
don't
Sanders
like
wasn't likable.
People like her.
I think there was something likable about Bernie.
To us. Because we like don't give a fuck. Most people don't like don't give a fuck. We're outliers. AOC gives a fuck. She's cute. She says things that people care about. She caters well without sounding super pandery to most people. I don't necessarily fuck with it. I'm also sexist. So, you know, we gotta be honest about who we are at a certain point.
Yeah. Right. I don't know. There's something about AOC to me, and it might be a political thing, but like she's kind of like virtuous, like gotcha. That's what every
a little
time
holier
I see
than thou for sure.
She's
and we'll see
than
how
thou.
Middle America feels. I don't have any idea. I thought Trump was going to get crushed in 2016. I'm obviously out of touch with what Middle America thinks.
Yeah.
But I just see a star when I see her. That's it.
Why?
It's just clear. Like when you watch her, she's got it. Whatever the fuck it is. They always say that, and it sounds so corny. But she's got more charisma than pretty much every politician outside of Trump. Trump got the most. You can't deny. I hate Trump or like Trump. This is a motherfucker you're watching. Yeah. AOC is the same. If she's on screen with three other candidates, you watching her. If she's on stage with fucking Buttigieg and Klobuchar and whatever the fuck, Elizabeth Warren, I'm watching AOC.
Son, she was a bartender.
Yeah.
That's a romantic story, yo.
Son, she knows how to talk to whatever crowd comes in her way.
And it's a story, too. That's a great point, actually. Yeah. She knows how to talk to everybody as a bartender, but also it's a story. You know, this is rags to riches. In our president, the bitch was a bartender. Every other president comes from money. Barack didn't. But outside of that, they all come from families, money, blah, 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 et cetera. She's a bartender. There's like romance to that.
When she
she's a
talks,
woman and she's cute.
When she talks, I this is what I go, ick. I go, when Barack Obama talks, I went like this. I went,
holy
whoa,
fuck. Yeah.
Whoa,
yeah, hey, that's true.
When George Bush talked, I went, this guy. When Trump talks, I go, this motherfucker is what? Like, I smile when they talk. Dude, FDR talked, you're into it. Like, if you go back to speeches, Abraham Lincoln, I don't know, I never heard him speak, so I can't, you know, whatever. But it's like, there is a fucking likability to them. When AOC talks, I literally look at the screen and I go, I hope one of the legs on her chair breaks. It's so annoying. She's so annoying to me.
That's fine.
Her little gotcha shit with Congress. We're like, so what did you say? So what, in 1946,
those are annoying. I'm
your grandmother once bought a bagel at a deli. Is she supporting the oppressive regime against Palestine? Like, what are you fucking
It's self-serving for sure.
Ugh.
But people love that.
Who?
People.
Who deep down loves that?
Son, that's Trump.
No.
Trump is mad self-serving. Every comment is, I'm the best. I do it the
Every
best.
Every politician is self-serving.
No. Yeah. What we love about Trump is not that. What we love about Trump, regardless if you like or hate his politics, what we love about Trump is humor. He is funny.
And he owns whatever he says, he owns it. He's unapologetic.
It's the same reason why 6ix9ine is going to come back completely unscathed.
Oh, my God. I disagree with that.
100%. 100%. 100%.
I wish he would stop.
He's already doing his comeback, by the way, 6ix9ine. Did you see? He was on Tory Lanez' live.
Nah.
And he goes, yo, let me play my new shit right now. I'm going to snitch on you.
He's funny. He is funny. I think he'll get got.
True, man.
Just as a
snitch. You're on the wrong side.
Say again?
On. You're on the wrong side with 6ix9ine, man.
Why?
Because he's a snitch.
Listen, I think that's super.
You're
scenes.
Acting like I care. It's not about sides. I'm just telling you what's going to happen in my opinion. What I believe is people care more about humor than they care about policy. Trump's policies are abhorrent to a lot of people, but he's so funny that people cannot stop watching him. I don't find AOC funny. She's never made me laugh once. George Bush was funny. Barack Obama was funny. AOC is not funny to me. She's an attractive woman. For a politician, she might be the most attractive woman. If she was ugly, people would be saying, shut your fat ass up. I literally think the only reason we listen to AOC is because she's attractive and her politics align with people. I literally think the only thing, I don't think there's to her outside of being attractive.
Every time I said she was a star.
We listen to Kim Kardashian and her opinions on black people in jail.
I mean, because she got some out. So.
Say what?
Because she got a few of them out.
You know how many people have gotten black people out of jail? But this bitch got a 30. So all of a sudden we're like, no, you got a good point.
Yo, you're right. But that's my point is she's cute. Every time I say she's a star, I say she's cute. That's one of the first things I name, if not the first.
You never that said matters. That one time.
Yeah, you I didn't say, cute. You didn't say that
one time.
You didn't say what time.
Listen
no,
to
did.
This shit. Listen to this this whole episode.
Run it back. Run it back.
You didn't say cute not one time.
Run it back.
You see this motherfucker be making.
You
see him trying to copyright shit.
Gagnon, where you at?
Every time I say this is the shit.
Gagnon, did I say she's cute?
I thought you were going out your way to not say it.
No, she's cute.
You didn't say one time that she's attractive.
She's cute multiple times. I can't wait to read the comment.
It factor, yeah. You're really talking like some Weinstein.
I said she was cute. I can't wait to see the comments. Run that shit back.
You go see these comments.
I can't wait, yo.
Listen, you didn't say it one time. You said that she had an it factor. You said, she's good at talking, and then you said
she's well spoken. She's cute.
She's never said
100%
she's cute.
Never said she's cute.
100%. Not even once you said she's cute.
She's cute.
No, I know.
That's
we
what
just
we
said
care
that.
About. That's all we care about. Not all.
You never
all
that, stop saying
no, that's
this.
Not all. That's not all.
You are backtracking.
That's
stop
not
the
all.
Moonwalking.
That's
son.
Not all.
Shut
I agree
up.
With you. If she's not cute, none of it matters.
Let's
but
say
if
hypothetically
she's cute,
saying you didn't say that.
What do you mean?
Hypothetically speaking, you didn't say any of that. Let's just say that. Hypothetically speaking, okay. You didn't say that. And all you said was what you said, which right. was she has an it factor.
Yeah.
Right?
The it factor, if she's not cute, it's not
why do you
there.
Think I would disagree with you and then say that she's hot and that's the only reason why people care?
Because you're disagreeing with me saying she is well-spoken, she is intelligent, she is whatever.
No,
but
I didn't
agree with you. That won't matter if she's ugly.
Yeah.
But she's not ugly. So that's why I think she's a star. Because she's cute and got the other shit. If she's just some cute, vapid bitch, all right, we're not voting for Kim Kardashian. I think we could in probably like 12 years. But we're not going to vote for just a cute bitch. But she's cute and got the other shit. That's why I think she's a star. I don't know her policies. That's it. That's why I think she got a shot.
We'll see in the comments.
We'll see in the comments. Yeah. And then if it is true that you didn't say she's cute, not even once, you probably didn't even talk about her looks at all, that would you like to apologize?
I'll apologize in the next episode. Okay. And when we find out
next
that
episode?
She is cute,
yeah,
when we find out she is cute,
yeah, yeah.
You're going to apologize?
Absolutely.
Okay. Okay, no. No, apology. No bullshit.
Absolutely. I'll apologize.
He almost started sounding like AOC.
If I'm wrong, I'm wrong, dog.
You go apologize, right?
100% it's going to be a shock apology. It's going to be, I'm sorry that you said that shit like a meek little bitch.
I know.
It's going to be the Schultz apology.
Yo, say it with your chest, bro. I don't know what to tell you, dog.